Hello, this is Rabbi Sammy Bergman of Beit Midrash Zichron Dov, and this is the sixth and final video in a series of videos discussing Jewish responses to destruction. I'd like to end the series with a Jewish leader and thinker who's very warm, I have a deep connection with in my heart, who lived much closer to our time, lived during the time of the Holocaust, and that is Rabbi Kalonymus Kalman Shapira, the Aish Kodesh, the Piazetian Rebbe, Zichrono, the Racha, Hashem Yikom Damo. Piazetian Rebbe was a grand rabbi of the Piazetian Hasidus. He was a world-renowned educator and an innovator in terms of the way education works. He wrote the famous book called Chovat HaTalmidim, which is a book written for people beginning their lives in Torah study. And he was a Jewish leader who tried his best to continue to inspire and motivate the Jews who lived during the Warsaw Ghetto. And unfortunately, in 1943, he was killed and shot shortly after the Warsaw Uprising. A few years after the war, his book was discovered, along with a lot of other works. And one of the works we discovered was that of the Aish Kodesh. Aish Kodesh is a compilation of different sermons that Kalonymus Kalman Shapira gave while he was actually in the ghetto and experiencing that suffering. And in the book, the Aish Kodesh demonstrates that one way of responding to suffering, responding to destruction, responding to difficulty, is through religious introspection, to produce new works of Torah, new ways of thinking about Torah and religion and God, based on the perspective of the destruction, of suffering. I'd like to share with you a brief thought from the Aish Kodesh. This is from the Aish Kodesh and on Shabbat Chazon. It's actually in my copy here, the last Dvar Torah we have from the Aish Kodesh. And he writes as follows. It says in regard to the Jewish people in Egypt, the Yomer Hashem Ra'ora Iti Et Ani Atami Asher Mitzrayim Etzakatam Shamati Mnei Nokzak Yadati Makovav. Hashem says, I've seen the pain of my nation in Mitzrayim, and I have heard their cries because of their oppressors. I know their pain. Ask the Rebbe, why do we need all these different languages describing how God is familiar with the pain of the Jewish people? Why do we need both the fact that he sees the pain, that he hears the cries, and that he knows the pain? What's the point of kiyadati, that God knows after he sees? Says the Rebbe, you can have a father who knows that it's good for his son to get a surgery, but at the actual moment when the child experiences that pain, can't look. It's too painful to watch. Even though he knows it's for the son's best interest, he can't actually watch the child experience pain. It's too hard. So he doesn't truly know it. He doesn't truly know that pain. He can't experience it. In Galut Mitzrayim, like all the other Galios, says the Rebbe, while he's experiencing the suffering is for the good of the Jewish people. God knows somehow it's for the good. But it's not just that he knows it's for the good, he watches it, he sees it. And says the Rebbe, Shabbat Chazon, Chazon Yeshayahu, Shabbat Chazon, which is literally translated, the Shabbat of vision. The Shabbat before Tisha B'Av is called the Shabbat of vision. Because the hardest thing to do is to see someone suffering. That's why we read this Haftorah on the Shavua Shachal, on the week before Tisha B'Av. Since we know that God sees the suffering of the Jewish people, that's how we can have the faith to continue fighting and hold true to the Torah and continue to try to bring the Yeshua, to bring the prosperity, to bring the salvation. It begins with Chazon, which is the hardest thing to see, and ends with Tzion Mishpati Padesh Aveh Betzaka. Then in the end, Tzion will be redeemed with judgment and those who return to it with righteousness. That knowledge that God sees our suffering, what the Piazetian Rebbe does through suffering, is to bring a new light to Torah, a new way of thinking of our tradition, a new emphasis, and an incredible ability to look at destruction and to use it as a tool for spirituality, to use it as a new way of thinking about our tradition, about our religion, about our Torah, about appreciating how God loves us even through the suffering. And I think that's the tradition that the Piazzetchna Rebbe leaves us with. And so I hope all of these perspectives and responses to destruction have been enlightening and inspiring for you. And let us hope that as we, in our time, and continue to properly internalize the suffering that we've experienced and chart a path forward in the future, hopefully the time comes when we no longer have to reminisce and think about the tragedies that have befallen us as a people. And as the Piazzetchna Rebbe envisioned, we will experience Zion being redeemed in righteousness.